Zahuria Shokanova, a borrower of the Center Credit Bank, also demands to invalidate her mortgage agreement. Supposedly, her agreement drafted back in 2007 violates the current legislation. The bank's reaction is still unknown, as its lawyer ignored the initial hearing on Tuesday, which effectively postponed the process.
Lawyer Denis Alimbekov says that a counterclaim was filed in response to Center Credit's intention to recover $18,000 from Shokanova, who owes the bank due to the unpaid loan. The borrower, however, claims that even after she and her husband lost their jobs, the family continued to repay the debt, although only $300 per month instead of $2,600. When the bank pressed charges, Shokanova demanded to recognize the loan agreement invalid because the bank granted the loan in US dollars, which contradicts the legislation of Kazakhstan. Also, after changing the method of loan repayment, the bank increased its profits by $70,000 at the expense of the borrower. Shokanova considers this money material damage. We believe that everything here contradicts the law. We already have the evidence ready. However, the consideration of the case is postponed, as the judge Nasibayeva still has some questions on the matter.
The development of Kazakh internet was discussed on Tuesday at the thematic conference in Almaty. Experts claimed domestic portals are ready to compete with similar sites in Russia while bringing substantial profits to their owners. The key requirement for now is the sharp division of authority in the field. Currently, though, the state continuously attempts to play the role of an overseer instead of full-fledged business partner.
Kaznet opportunities and issues of its development were discussed on Tuesday at the first conference KIV 2010. The new discussion site was set up as a commercial project. There are rich people in Kazakhstan, however, they think that innovations in Kazakhstan are flawed and they are afraid of Kaznet in general. The few recognizable projects have a lot to share about the reverse side of success. Website Nur.kz is accused of increasing its traffic through porn links, while the message board Center Tyazhesti was blocked in spring at court's order due to owners fighting over their rights. There is also the unofficial ban on the independent news from the portal Respublika, which can be accessed only through foreign proxy service. The state gives you something with one hand but takes away with the other. The government allocates enormous funds for the net's development but doesn't let us to develop at the same time. The conference participants calculated that on average the annual volume of state investment into Kaznet in the last 5 years reached $90 million. Users, though, still complain about low speeds, errors and connection difficulties. The legal base is also absent. The previously mentioned blocking of websites cannot be contested in any legal way. Special mechanisms and technical regulations need to be developed to give us more opportunities to act. No one has ever approached this matter yet. Unfortunately, these and other critical issues were not discussed with officials. The Information and Communications Minister didn't show up for the conference, although he was declared as a participant. This once again proved the opinion that state programs alone are not enough, and business as well as society in general needs to be interested in Kaznet's development.
This is it for now. Thank you for watching us. Goodbye.